Hello, today I like to show you CYK parsing with deduction rules. CYK parsing, at least in the basic version of the algorithm, only works for grammars in Chomsky normal form. That means there are two possible forms of production rules. One is we have two non-terminal symbols on the right-hand side, exactly two. This corresponds to this production rule or to this one. Or we have production rules with exactly one terminal symbol on the right-hand side. So that could be these three production rules. Or in some implementations, it's allowed to have a start symbol epsilon production if the start symbol does not occur in any right-hand side. So the grammar will be able to include the empty input string. The algorithm works bottom-up, that means it starts at the input string and works itself upwards towards the start symbol. But contrary to other algorithms, there's no defined order in which this happens. The items consist of a non-terminal symbol and two indices. The first index says where the span of this item starts, and the second one is the length of the span or of the item span. In some implementations, the second index denotes the end of the span instead of the length. Then, when we start, we consider all production rules with one terminal symbol on the right-hand side, and we match them with the input symbols. And for each combination of right-hand side of input symbol, we create one item in our table. So, for instance, if we had two production rules with an A on the right-hand side, we would create two items for the first A in the word. But in this case, there's only one for each. Now we have those items. A expands to A for the first symbol in the input string. And this gives us this item, which starts off at position 0, so before the first symbol, and has length 1. Then we have the B. B expands to B for the second item, which gives us the second position, which gives us this item that starts at position 1 and also has length 1. Or the third one, the C, for the third position, which starts at position 2 and has length 1. Now for going up further, and now this is all we could do with the production rules that have a terminal symbol on the right-hand side. Now for further processing, we only need the other production rules with two non-terminals on the right-hand side. And now, as you can see in the tree, we now want to combine the B and the C item to get a new item X with a span over both. So now from here now on, we use the complete rule. In the first position, we put the B item. And because this starts at index 1 and has length 1, so the next item that has to start at position 2, so that they are two just beside each other. So this one can only be combined with this C item that starts immediately behind this. And we can then link them together with this production rule with B and C on the right hand side, and it will give us a new item X that starts at index 1 and has a length of 2, so exactly the span over our previous two items. Now the next step, as you can see in the tree, we now want to combine A and X to get an S. So again, we are using the complete rule to combine A and X. And we are using this production rule that matches the two items together. And now we got our S item that starts at index 0 and has a span over the whole tree. So in this case, a span of 3. And whenever this is the case, this is exactly corresponds to our goal item, and the passing process was successful. Now, as you can see, the grammars, this algorithm, at least in this implementation, handles is very limited, so it can only handle grammars in Chomsky normal form. But it takes often very few steps and is very quick to process and is very efficient. And that was CYK parsing.